Now, Choral Evensong, which today we are only able to broadcast in mono due to technical difficulties. This afternoon's service comes from the Chapel of New College, Oxford. The Canticles are sung to the verse service by Edmund Hooper, and the anthem is Gloria in Excelsis Deo by Weelkes.
The grace of God has dawned upon the world with healing for all mankind.
O Lord, open thou our lips,
and our mouths shall sing for thy grace.
O God, make speed to save us.
O Lord, make haste to help.
Psalms 114 and 115.
Peace for hand and flesh.
The book of the prophet Micah, chapter 4. It shall come to pass in the latter days that the mountain of the house of the Lord shall be established as the highest of the mountains, and shall be raised up above the hills, and peoples shall flow to it, and many nations shall come and say, Come, let us go up to the mountain of the Lord, to the house of the God of Jacob, that he may teach us his ways, and we may walk in his paths. For out of Zion shall go forth the law, and the word of the Lord from Jerusalem. He shall judge between many peoples, and shall decide for strong nations afar off, and they shall beat their swords into plowshares, and their spears into pruning hooks. Nation shall not lift up sword against nation, neither shall they learn war any more. But they shall sit every man under his vine and under his fig tree, and none shall make them afraid, for the mouth of the Lord of hosts has spoken. For all the peoples walk, each in the name of its God, but we will walk in the name of the Lord our God, forever and ever. In that day, says the Lord, I will assemble the lame and gather those who have been driven away, and those whom I have afflicted. And the lame I will make the remnant, and those who were cast off a strong nation. And the Lord will reign over them in Mount Zion from this time forth and forevermore. And you, O tower of the flock, hill of the daughter of Zion, to you shall it come, the former dominion shall come, the kingdom of the daughter of Jerusalem. Now why do you cry aloud? Is there no king in you? Has your counselor perished, that pangs have seized you like a woman in travail? Writhe and groan, O daughter of Zion, like a woman in travail. For now you shall go forth from the city and dwell in the open country. You shall go to Babylon. There you shall be rescued. There the Lord will redeem you from the hand of your enemies. Now many nations are assembled against you, saying, Let her be profaned, and let our eyes gaze upon Zion. But they do not know the thoughts of the Lord. They do not understand his plan, that he has gathered them as sheaves to the threshing floor. Arise and thresh, O daughter of Zion, for I will make your horn iron and your hoofs bronze, and ye shall beat in pieces many peoples, and shall devote their gain to the Lord, their wealth to the Lord of the whole earth. Here ends the first lesson.
Thank you.
First letter of Paul to the Corinthians, chapter 3. But I, brethren, could not address you as spiritual men, but as men of the flesh, as babes in Christ. I fed you with milk, not solid food, for you were not ready for it. And even yet you are not ready, for you are still of the flesh. For while there is jealousy and strife among you, are you not of the flesh, and behaving like ordinary men? For when one says, I belong to Paul, and another, I belong to Apollos, are you not merely men? What then is Apollos? What is Paul? Servants through whom you believed, as the Lord assigned to each. I planted, Apollos watered, but God gave the growth. So neither he who plants nor he who waters is anything, but only God who gives the growth. He who plants and he who waters are equal, and each shall receive his wages according to his labor. For we are fellow workers for God. You are God's field, God's building. According to the commission of God given to me, another man is building upon it. Let each man take care how he builds upon it. For no other foundation can anyone lay than that which is laid, which is Jesus Christ. Now if anyone builds on the foundation with gold, silver, precious stones, wood, hay, stubble, each man's work will become manifest, for the day will disclose it, because it will be revealed with fire. And the fire will test what sort of work each one has done. If the work which any man has built on the foundation survives, he will receive a reward. If any man's work is burned up, he will suffer loss, though he himself will be saved, but only as through fire. Do you not know that you are God's temple, and that God's Spirit dwells in you? If anyone destroys God's temple, God will destroy him. For God's temple is holy, and that temple you are. Let no one deceive himself. If anyone among you thinks that he is wise in this age, let him become a fool, that he may become wise. For the wisdom of this world is folly with God. For it is written, he catches the wise in their craftiness. And again, the Lord knows that the thoughts of the wise are futile. So let no one boast of men. For all things are yours, whether Paul or Apollos or Cephas or the world or life or death, or the present or the future, all are yours, and you are Christ's, and Christ is God's. Here ends the second lesson.
Thank you.
I believe in God. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray.
Lord, have mercy.
Govern all things in heaven and earth. Mercifully hear the supplications of thy people, and grant us thy peace all the days of our life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
O God, from whom all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works do proceed, give unto thy servants that peace which the world cannot give, that our hearts may be set to obey thy commandments, and that by thee, we being defended from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness. through the merits of Jesus Christ, our Savior.
Amen.
Lighten our darkness, we beseech thee, O Lord, and by thy great mercy, defend us from all perils and dangers of this night. For the love of thy only Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The anthem, Gloria in Excelsis Deo, music by Thomas Weelkes. Let us pray. In this week of prayer for Christian unity, we pray first for the divided churches. We pray also that God's healing power will bring peace and justice among men and nations. We pray thee, O Lord our God, to set the peace of heaven within the hearts of men, that it may bind the nations also in a covenant which cannot be broken, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We ask for God's blessing on all who are sick, the suffering and the anxious, at home or in hospital, and we pray for all who at this time seek God's strength and protection. We commend to thy merciful care, O Lord, all who are passing through suffering and distress, beseeching thee to grant them, according to their need, peace of heart, strength of body, and healing of the mind, for the sake of Jesus Christ, our Savior.
Amen.
Finally, we pray for the community of this college, that through his Holy Spirit, God will inspire our work and worship. Father, who through six centuries hast blessed this college, which is called by the name of thy lowly handmaiden, for a house of sound learning and faithful service, we praise thee for the gifts we have received and for thy goodness which we enjoy. Grant to us in this place to use our knowledge and freedom for the benefit of others, that in all things thy name may be magnified, and thy kingdom of justice and mercy advanced among us, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Hymn in the English hymnal 43.
Thank you.
Choral Evensong came today from the chapel of New College, Oxford. The organist and master of the choristers was Edward Higginbottom, and the organ scholar was John Keyes. Next Wednesday at 4 o'clock, Choral Evensong comes again from New College.